We both just bought houses here. So we just decided, you know what, to hell with it, let's do it. Let's find an old house in a cool part of town, turn it into a writing room and maybe into a studio.
We decided to do things a little differently this time. We weren't in a formal studio. Because Ryan does a lot of recording and writing, he has so much gear collected that we decided to put all that and rent a house, just put it in the house.
I'd been buying recording equipment for years. I have gear upstairs in this house that's the equivalent to any studio in Los Angeles.
It took forever to find the right house with the right kind of rooms because you're not in a formal studio, so now you're sort of using the natural ambient reverb of different rooms, and so we needed to find a house that we not only would be comfortable and that people could stay in when they came to record, but that would also have different room environments for mic placements, you know, especially drums.
I had a buddy of mine from LA fly out and scope out a bunch of places. We ended up picking this house. We had a church picked out, and we lost it at the last minute, so we picked out this house. Quiet, cool neighborhood, and no one really knows we're here, which is cool. And there's plenty of room. This is where we wrote some of the songs and recorded them back behind here. We had drum kits set up. We had all kinds of stuff everywhere.
Downstairs is where we wrote and hashed out songs and then came up and recorded them in various rooms around the house.
I think it's about 7,000 square feet. It's ridiculously big. So we've utilized most of the rooms. This room is the one we did a lot of demos in. We still record guitar and bass down here. We have a bass amp over there and a handful of the guitars over here and amps. So we track electric guitar down here. And the cool thing about this house, well, A, it doesn't sound like a studio. So when you hear this album, you'll hear sounds. You may not know why it sounds different than some albums, but it's because it was done in a house. You can hear the master bedroom, for instance. Every time you hear the piano on this album or cello, you're hearing the sound of the master bedroom of this house. That's the sound of it. The vocal booth is the closet for the master bedroom. The drums are the upstairs office area. It's cool because the upstairs of this house has this, like, I don't know, it's all wood. It's really like dark mahogany wood. And it has this kind of open area about the size of this room, but then a staircase behind it leading up to a giant loft where you can look at the Rocky Mountains. Like, you have an unobstructed view of downtown Denver and the Rocky Mountains. So we have mics set up to get the drums here, and then mics about 20 feet above in a loft. So you get this, you can make drums sound like Led Zeppelin, massive, just huge reverb.
By the time, you know, we had our engineer come out and do drums, that was amazing. That sort of reinvented the songs for me, just to hear like what he did with drums, you know, just putting them in different places in the room.
The center room is the mother brain of the ship. We went to Pottery Barn and bought every red velvet curtain they had to block all the windows, because the only thing separating us from outside is essentially windows and these big French doors. We have all my gear. I've been collecting recording studio gear and guitars and amps and mics for 3 or 4 years now. You know, so everything that's upstairs is kind of the summary of everything I've been gathering in the last few years. We put it all up there and basically wired it up like a traditional studio. It's just mobile, and it's a living room. We're in a living room. It has a stone, like an old, like Spanish stone floor and beamed ceilings and a chandelier and a kitchen behind it. And we literally track the whole album. The control room is the living room. There's a fireplace actually right behind the control desk, and then a Van Gogh print that we bought. As I said, I'm really inspired by paintings, and I love Van Gogh, so we put a Van Gogh, my wife got me one of those.
We didn't want it to be a high-stress, like, hurried sort of project. We wanted to take our time, so I think that alleviated a lot of the traditional stresses of recording.
What's great about recording in this album is that when you're sitting in the control room, you're only 10 minutes from the fridge, and, you know, 2 seconds, you can walk outdoors. It's really, really different. So organic. That's part of the reason we did it. The thought of going to LA, I've spent 6 years there, and the thought of staying there and paying $2,000 a day for a studio, which they all look like laboratories, you know, and you feel stressed. I feel stressed when I know, like, okay, we didn't do much today and we just spent $2,000 of our budget. I didn't want to feel time pressure. So we rented this house for 5 months, I think, 5 or 6 months. It couldn't have been better. You know, we've had good engineers and good people out here.
We really just threw everything at each song and then sort of picked it apart. Does this work? Does this not? And it was a very calm experience.
To me, that last part of the process, in a way it was challenging, but definitely the most work that went into the record, I think, was going in with a very loose agenda of we were going to do this 100% different and 100% our way. Do you think I'm special? Do you think I'm nice? Am I bright enough to shine in your spaces? Between the noise you hear and the sound you like, are we just sinking in the ocean of faces?
Brent and Drew, we all love like hiking and fly fishing and camping. And Denver for me is, I've been to 49 of the 50 states multiple times. I've played almost all of them. I've lived in 5 different states from New York to Los Angeles. I've done my time all over the country. And there's a lot of places I love. I like San Fran, I like New York, I like Nashville, you know, but Denver is my favorite city. And I had the option after this last OneRepublic album, my wife and I had the choice to pick where we wanted to live, and we picked Denver. She's from here, and my whole family lives in Colorado Springs, so this is the best place to do it. It's 2 hours from LA, so it's a no-brainer. Denver's got anything that I could possibly want. Challenges emotionally on this record are when you're not writing from a place of desperation. Oftentimes the first album for most artists is so monumental because they're writing from a place of destitution. All an album is to me is a snapshot of where you are in life and creatively at that moment. So this album is a snapshot of everything, you know, that I've absorbed and this band has absorbed in the last, you know, 4 or 5 years. The challenge emotionally, I think, is to tap into something real.
We came off tour, and I think we were all completely different men.
I think we had a lot more to write about on
yeah,
this album.
Definitely.
We'd seen a bunch of the world, you know, just experienced a ton together.
The traveling that we did on the first album, thank God for that. Over a 15-month period, OneRepublic, we played 27 countries. We did over 230 dates in 15 months. And going from a band who averaged 2 shows a month to that was crazy. That influenced me. Our first album came out. Again, it came out 4 years after it was supposed to. So we had already kind of evolved past then. Because the way we came out off a remix and off Timbaland's album, we got kind of panned by a lot of people. A lot of people like, oh, they just brushed us off, whether it was fans or critics or you name it. Just kind of thought we were a flash in the pan, one-hit wonder, got lucky, Timbaland made our careers, all this stuff. And for someone like me who's worked so hard for so many years and literally sacrificed everything in my life to get here, hearing negativity directed at me or this band was, I'm not the kind of person that just takes that and smiles and turns the other cheek. I'm like, it fuels me, actually. It fuels me. We're not lucky. This was effort, and we know what we're doing, and we want to push. If we're going to be on radio, then we're going to push radio as far as it'll go. And if we're going to be a band, then we're either each album making a progression, reaching more fans and getting bigger, or we're done. There is no middle ground. There is no status quo for me. It's one way or the other. first album.